हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल सी द टाइप्स ऑफ रोटेशंस, दैट इज 3D रोटेशंस। सो द फर्स्ट टाइप अमंग द जनरल 3D रोटेशंस इज रोटेशन अबाउट एन एक्सिस पैरेलल टू वन ऑफ द कोऑर्डिनेट एक्सिस। सो एज यू कैन सी ओवर हियर, आई हैव ड्रॉन दिस एक्स वाई जेड 3 डायमेंशनल एक्सिस सिस्टम एंड आई हैव दिस line or axis, whatever you can call it, okay, is parallel to x-axis. Okay, this line p1 p2 or axis p1 p2 is parallel to x-axis, and the rotation needs to be carried out about this line p1 p2 or axis p1 p2. So that is why the case is rotation about an axis or line parallel to one of the coordinate axes. Okay, so this axis p1 p2 is actually parallel to x-axis. Then when it is parallel, when my reference of rotation is not a coordinate axis, okay, when my reference of rotation is not one of the coordinate axis, then I will have to make it the coordinate axis and then I can carry the rotation. Now, since this required reference, that is p1 p2, is parallel to one of the coordinate axis, okay, my job is very easy. What I have to do, I have to just translate it to the origin by the required amount, okay, and then I can perform the specified rotation about that axis, and then I can translate the object, that is the line, back to the original position so that the rotation can be completed. Okay, so let's say the requirement is like, I have object over here, okay, I have object over here, any shape object, and this needs to be rotated in 3-dimensional space, okay, with respect to this axis p1 p2, okay, with respect to this axis p1 p2, and in order to do that, we first have to make this axis p1 p2 as one of the coordinate axes, okay, as one of the coordinate axes, and that is what we are doing here. The first step that we do is we translate the object so that the rotation axis coincides with the parallel coordinate axis. So I will have to first write the translation matrix. Okay, translation matrix. I will just write here TR. Okay. Then I would write a required rotation matrix. Okay, and then I would again write a translation matrix. Okay, now since we are going to back translate in the first time, so I will write here back translation, okay, multiplied by the rotation, pre-multiplied by the forward translation, is nothing but the required transformation. All these activities I will be applying on the object matrix. Okay, all the activities I will be applying on the object matrix. Okay, now taking the reference of the same case, okay, taking the reference of the same case, I will write, let's say, the transformation okay, I will start from the far right, that is the object matrix. I will keep on the extreme right end. Okay, then I will have the translation to carry. So it is going to be 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 0, and then I will have TX TY TZ1. Remember, this is going to be a 3-dimensional translation, so we are not saying that this p1 p2 is in any plane. Okay, it is open, okay, it is open in the 3-dimensional space, so it is not in xy plane. It doesn't have to be in xy plane. Okay, even if it is open, still we can translate it. Okay, still we can translate it and make it the one of the coordinate axes. This time we are going to make it as x-axis. Okay, so I will have to carry x-axis rotation. Okay, I will have to carry the x-axis rotation. So for that, I will be writing 1 0 0 0, then 0 cos theta minus sin theta cos theta 0 0 1 0 0 0, that is the rotation with respect to x. Now as far as this condition is concerned, it is going to be the rotation with respect to x. So I can write here rx. I can write here rx, and then I will be, since this is the back translation, so I will have to put negative signs so that this will become origin. Okay, this will become origin. Okay, and since this particular line is parallel to x-axis, so we may find that the x-coordinate is, the x-translation is not required basically. It only requires a y-translation and z-translation, but this is a general transformation matrix for translation I have written for back translation in 3D. So it may happen that tx is 0. Okay, it may happen that tx is 0. So that is understandable. And then I will have a forward translation. 1 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 acceleration, that is dx, dy, dz, 1, to take it back to the original location. So as far as the rotation about an axis parallel to one of the coordinate axes is concerned, okay, we carry out these three operations. We first back translate the object to the so that the rotation axis coincides with one of the parallel coordinate axes. Then perform the specified rotation, that is the second case, which is this. Okay, perform the rotation, and then the third case. So the sequence of the multiplications is, this is my first case, okay, this is my second case, and this is my third case, and whatever object that I have, okay, remains to be on the extreme right hand side. Okay, so I hope this point is clear. Okay, it's not that difficult to carry out these multiplications. Okay, the order of matrices for all these multiplications is going to be 4 by 4. Okay, it's going to be 4 by 4. So next up we will see the second case. Okay, that is the rotation about an axis not parallel to any coordinate axis. Okay, so now we will see the rotation about an axis not parallel to one of the coordinate axes. So the condition that we are looking after is this. So this P1, P2, okay, is not parallel to one of the axes. So it is not parallel to any of the axes. Now it is up to us to decide, okay, we make P1, P2 parallel to which axis. Okay, so we have to first translate it to the origin, one of the reference point of that axis. We need to translate to the origin. So let us say we'll translate P1 to the origin. Okay, then we will rotate the P2 dash onto the z axis. So then the rotation will happen by keeping this P1 fixed. Okay, by keeping this P1 fixed, and in order to carry out this rotation, we'll have to actually carry out two separate rotations. Okay, we'll have to actually carry out two separate rotations, and then it will align with z axis. Okay, once it is aligned with z axis, then we will rotate by the required amount. Okay, we will rotate the object by the required degree, that is being asked. Okay, so rotate the object around the z-axis. This is the required rotation. This is the required rotation. And then again we will rotate the axis to the original orientation. So I said in order to carry out the step 2, okay, from step 1, okay, I actually require two rotations. Okay, so I will require two reverse rotations, okay, to again take the object to the step 1 location, and then I will translate the object back to the original shape. So in order to carry out these steps, okay, in order to carry out these steps, few more calculations have to be performed. So as I said, we will assume the rotation axis will be the z axis about which we are going to carry out the rotation. So step number 3, that is very very well defined, that is rotation will be carried out about z axis. That is convenient. Okay, that is convenient. We can actually align that axis p1 p2 to any of the coordinate axis. Okay, the operations are going to remain same, but if we decide to align it to other coordinate axis, then the matrix will change. Okay, the matrices will change. So okay, we'll begin with the axis vector. I'll take a different color. Okay, we'll begin with the axis vector. So axis vector v, for that axis p1 p2 is given by p2 minus p1 is given by p2 minus p1, which is nothing but, okay, the difference of their coordinates. So it is x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, and z2 minus z1. Okay, now similarly the unit vector, u, is defined along the rotation axis. Okay, in this particular manner. So I'll write u as v divided by mod v. These are the basic definitions which we are carrying out. Okay, and this is expressed in terms of ABC, where ABC are what? My direction cosines. Okay, ABC of unit vector u are direction cosines. Okay, for rotation axis. And their individual values are given by, I'll just write it here. A equal to x2 minus x1 upon mod v, b equal to y2 minus y1 upon mod of v, and c is equal to z2 minus z1 upon mod of v. Okay, so that is how we define the unit vector. Okay, that is how we define the unit vector. Okay, now we are doing P2 minus P1 because rotation is in counterclockwise direction, that is by default. Okay, rotation is counterclockwise direction, that is by default. So that means the rotation will be carried out while the observer is looking from point P2 towards point P1. Okay, that is the direction that we are assuming. Okay, and that is the, so the rotation will be carried out when the observer is looking from this direction. This direction, so that is the observer direction, and then we are carrying out the counterclockwise rotation. Okay, if the rotation is going to be clockwise, then we will reverse the this axis vectors. So then it will be x1 minus x2, y1 minus y2, z1 minus z2, and then remaining things will remain as it is. Okay, and the rotation will be in opposite direction. Okay, rotation will be in opposite direction. So having said that, okay, we will now write the first step. Okay, we will now write the first step. So first step is the translation. I will write here back translation. Instead of T inverse, okay, it's better to write TR here and inverse here. And then the coordinates of point P1, okay, I will be translating back to the origin. So it is minus x1 minus y1 minus z1 1. Okay, this is going to be my first step, that is the translation. So this is my step number 1 I just carried out. Okay, I just carried out this step and translated this P1 from this to origin, okay, here to P1 dash. Then I will require two separate rotations. Okay, then I will require two separate rotations. So now what has happened? In order to carry out this step 2. Okay, now the object is basically okay, right now the object is lying in this manner. P1 coinciding with the coordinate origin. Okay, but if you just pay attention, okay, it is still in the three-dimensional space. Okay, it is still in three-dimensional space. So let's say if I have the axis something like this. Okay, if I have to showcase this with the book. Okay, so if it is in this way, okay, and this is the third plane. Okay, then it is right now lying in this manner. It is right now lying in this manner. Okay, so we'll have to first project it onto one of the planes. Okay, we'll have to first project it onto one of the planes, and then only the rotation is possible. Okay, then only the rotation is possible. So what we do here is, okay, as you can see, we are holding this axis in three dimensional space, okay, still it is not parallel to any of the coordinate axes. So if I am able to project it onto, let's say, this is my x direct, x axis, y axis, z axis. So if I am able to project it by throwing some light from this direction along the x direction, so what will happen is, okay, let me also call this as the vector u. Okay, if I am going to project it, let's say, and throw some light, then I will get the projection onto the xz plane. Okay, I will get the projection onto the xz plane. So this I will call as u dash. Okay, this I will call as u dash. Okay, so this is a projection. Okay, this is a projection. My actual axis is still here. Okay, my actual axis is still here at u. Okay, what I did, I just put a light source in the x direction towards the origin. Okay, from the x direction towards the origin, and I got shadow. Okay, I got shadow of this axis onto this yz plane, and then I got this reference rotation angle alpha, which is required to rotate this shadow about x axis. Okay, which is required to rotate this shadow about x axis. I can carry out rotation of the shadow, okay, by angle alpha, so that this shadow aligns itself with z. Okay, aligns itself with z, and in doing so, okay, it drops my u into xz plane. Okay, it drops my u into xz plane. Okay, so I hope you are following. So in order to do that, okay, now since this u dash is in yz plane, so the coordinates of u dash in terms of its direction cosines are given by 0 BC. Okay, 0 BC. So then I will have to carry out the rotation, okay, rotation for the u dash, that is the projection vector of u onto the yz plane, and the alignment that I have to achieve is with z. Okay, is with z. So I can call this z axis also as one of the unit vectors as uz with coordinates 0, 0, 1. So now I will have to find out the cross product, and right now since the alpha angle is involved, so I will first find out the dot product. Okay, dot product. So I will find the dot product of u dash and uz. Okay, why I am finding this dot product? So that I can align u dash on uz, or I can align u dash on z axis, and in doing so I will be dropping my u, that is p1 p2, onto the xz plane. Okay, onto the xz plane. I wanted the reference angle alpha, so that is why I am doing this activity, because rotation, as I said, is a planar phenomena, and it can happen only if I have a planar reference. So this alpha, finding alpha, okay, if I have to find the reference angle alpha, first I have to make some arrangement to take my u into the yz plane. Okay, to take my u into the yz plane, and that is what we have done. We have projected u, okay, onto the yz plane in terms of u dash, and now I have u dash, which is a representation of u in the yz plane. Okay, representation of u in the yz plane. So if I have to find out the cos of angle using the dot product, okay, so I will be writing u dash dot uz is given by cos of alpha. So from here I would require cos of alpha as u dash dot uz divided by mod of u dash multiplied by mod of uz. Okay, now we know that u dash mod of u dash in terms of its direction cosines is given by under root b square plus c square. Okay, let us call this as d for the time being. Okay, and since uz is a unit vector, okay, so this will give us 1. Okay, this will give us 1, and if I represent this back into this, so I get this as 3 by d. Okay, this is 3 by d. Okay, so from where I got 3 by d? Okay, this is c because the dot product, what are the coordinates? This is 0, b, c. Okay, dot 0, 0, 1. So what is remaining? Only c is remaining, and here I just found out that this is b square plus c square multiplied by 1. So if I further simplify this, I eventually get, from the multiplication from top, I get c, and this under root b square plus c square, we have just called it as d. So then I got cos alpha as c by d. So this is my first observation. Similarly, as I have found the dot product, I can also find the cross product to determine the sine of alpha. So cross product is given as u dash cross uz is equal to the unit vector, that is ux coming out, in u dash uz sine of alpha. Okay, so this is the general cross product definition. And there is also one more cross product definition, that is the Cartesian form of cross product. Okay, so we will also use that. Okay, so in that we write u dash cross uz equal to ux into b. So now if we compare both these, the left hand sides, then we can compare the right hand sides. So if we compare that, we get ux into b equal to ux into mod of u into mod of uz sine alpha. Okay, this unit vectors will get cut. And we are left with, as you can see, this mod of u dash multiplied by mod of uz, that multiplication we have already got it as is under root b square plus c square, which eventually is d, which eventually is d. So this will eventually give us b equal to d sin alpha. So I can write sin alpha as b by d. Sin alpha as b by d. So now I have got both the angles. Okay, now I have got both the angles, cos alpha as well as sin alpha. Now I can carry out the x rotation. Okay, now I can carry out the x rotation. And what this x rotation is gonna do? This x rotation is going to take my u, that is right now in the 3D space, onto the xz plane eventually. Why? Because what we are doing, we are basically rotating its projection vector onto the yz plane by angle alpha. Okay, by angle alpha. So that's what we have done. So then I can write the matrix for rotation of u about x axis. So I will write it as Rx alpha is going to be 1 0 0 0. Okay, I will write it in terms of the cos alpha sin alpha. So cos alpha we have identified as c by d, sin alpha minus b by d, then it is b by d, and again c by d, 0 0 0 0 1. Okay, so this is my actually one of the rotations. Okay, one of the rotations in my step 2. Okay, now after this rotation, okay, after this rotation, what has happened? This u dash, okay, this u dash actually came down. Okay, because of this, what happened? This u dash actually came down in xz plane, and I represent it with u double dash. Okay, I represent it with u double dash. Okay, so now it is in this manner. This is u double dash, this is x, this is y, this is z. Remember what we did over here is we carried x rotation. Okay, we carried x rotation. So this alpha basically, you know, what we rotated this projection vector with. So we actually carried the x rotation. Okay, we actually carried the x rotation. Now, in order to align this u double dash to z, okay, our real vector is now u double dash. Okay, that was the projection vector. Now this u double dash we need to rotate so that it again coincides with the z axis in this manner. Okay, so I have the direction cosines for the u double dash as a 0 and d, and again I will have here uz is the unit vector in z axis, that is 0 0 1. Okay, that is 0 0 1. Now I will again follow the same procedure. So first I will be finding the cross product of these two, and from there I will find the cos of beta angle. So this is the rotation angle beta that I am looking for. Okay, this is the rotation angle beta. So cos beta can be given as u double dash dot uz divided by mod of u double dash into mod of uz, okay, which is given as, again, okay, on the similar lines, this is a cross product multiplication. So I have my direction cosines dot 001 divided by, okay, it is going to be a square plus d square multiplied by 1, okay, multiplied by 1. So eventually when I simplify, as you can see, I will get on the numerator I will have only d, and in the denominator I will have only a square plus d square. Okay, now what is d? Okay, d square is nothing but, d is nothing but under root b square plus c square. Okay, so when I put d square inside the denominator, okay, I eventually get it as this d divided by under root a square plus b square plus c square. Okay, a square plus b square plus c square. Okay, now we know that for the unit vectors or the direction cosines, when you square them and put in the square root, okay, the value that eventually comes out is, value that eventually comes out is 1. So this typically turns out to be d divided by 1, which is d. So my cos beta is d. My cos beta is d. And now I will be finding the sine beta with the help of cross products. Okay, sine beta with the help of cross product. So I know that u double dash cross uz is equal to the unit vector ui sine of beta, and with the Cartesian form, Cartesian form of cross products, okay, I know that u double dash cross uz is given by ui multiplied by minus a. See, we are following the Cartesian form of cross product, so the multiplication is in the order, okay, matrix order. So I guess you follow this, okay, Cartesian form of cross product. So when I compare both, okay, when I compare both the right hand sides, okay, right hand sides, I eventually get as I eventually get this particular thing. So it is ui multiplied by minus a is equal to ui u double dash uz sine of beta. So this ui will get cut. Okay, we already know that the u double dash, okay, u double dash is what? It is a square plus d square, okay, a square plus d square, which eventually is under root a square plus b square plus c square, okay, a square plus b square plus c square. So it is like multiplied by 1 multiplied by sine beta is equal to minus of a. Okay, and that is the reason why sine beta is minus of a. Sine beta is minus of a. Okay, so this is what we have got. Okay, then we will write the rotation of the ry beta. Okay, so rotation that is need to be carried out about axis y, because now we have got both the values of cos beta and sin beta. Okay, we have got both the values of sin beta and cos beta. So then we will write the matrix as the transformation matrix for rotation about y axis, that is ry beta, as d 0 minus a 0 0 1 0 0 a 0 d 0 0 0 0 1. Remember, these signs are getting interchanged because sine beta value we have got minus of a. Okay, so actually here it is sine beta and here it is minus sine beta. Okay, so okay, and with this now we are ready for the actual z multiplication, the actual z axis multiplication. So what we have achieved, okay, we have now aligned eventually this particular we have aligned this u double dash exactly on top of the z axis. Okay, and now we are ready for the z rotation. Okay, now we are ready for the z rotation. So that we will carry out now. Okay, so this is going to be the actual step 3. The required degree. So once we are done with this, then we just have to carry out all these operations in a reverse way. So then I will have to rotate it in the minus beta angle, okay, to align it back to, or to take it back into the xz plane, and then rotate it with minus alpha angle with respect to x to take it back to this, and then I will have to back translate it to its original position. Okay, back translate it to its original position. So that is the remaining set of operations. So if I just have to write the entire set of matrix multiplications, I will write it over here, r theta. Okay, I will start from the extreme right hand side, that is the inverse translation. Okay, inverse translation. Then I have rx alpha rotation. Then I have ry beta rotation. Okay, and then I have rz theta, that is the actual rotation. Okay, and then in the same sequence, so it is going to be ry minus of, let's say, beta is the reverse rotation. Then it is going to be the rx reverse of alpha, and then there will be a forward translation. So steps wise, this is going to be step 1, this is what we carried out as step 2. Okay, this is step 3. This is going to be combined step 4, and this last is going to be step 5. Okay, this last is going to be step 5. So it actually involves 7 matrix multiplications, and then we will be able to successfully rotate the object, okay, with respect to a line which is not parallel to one of the coordinate axes. So I hope you have understood. Okay, next time we will solve few problems on this to make this topic completely understandable. Okay, so I shall see you next time. Thank you.